Building a nuclear weapon starts with uranium or plutonium. These are different pathways. Uranium is found in nature, with about 99.3% of uranium-238 and 0.7% of uranium-235. The uranium-235 is the key ingredient for nuclear power plant fuel and for weapons. The raw uranium is mined and enriched, bringing the uranium-235 to between 4% and 5% to create fuel for a nuclear reactor to produce electricity. About a fifth of American electricity comes from nuclear power plants using fuel like this. In order to create a uranium nuclear bomb, you can't just use that fuel as it is. Nuclear weapons use uranium enriched up to about 90% uranium-235. We are dramatically restricting the amount of enriched uranium that they can have on hand. Iran will reduce its stockpile of enriched uranium by 98%, from 12,000 kilograms to only 300 kilograms. Iran will reduce the number of centrifuges enriching uranium to just over 5,000 for the next decade, from almost 20,000 today. And for the next 10 years, only the oldest and least capable model of centrifuges will be allowed to operate. Right now, Iran has enough enriched uranium for about 10 bombs. And if Iran wanted to acquire a nuclear weapon, it would take only 2 or 3 months for it to enrich enough uranium to a high enough level to produce a bomb. If Iran did decide that it wanted to race to a weapon, it would start with so few machines and so little uranium that it would take them a year to reach enough material for even a single first bomb. Plutonium, on the other hand, does not exist in nature. It is generated in the fuel of a normally operating nuclear reactor when a uranium-238 atom absorbs a neutron. When used solely to produce electricity, reactors would not produce plutonium with the quality of that used in a nuclear weapon. But just to make sure, Iran has agreed to take all of the irradiated fuel that contains the plutonium and send it out of the country. So we feel very, very secure that the plutonium pathway is very, very well blocked. To be clear, this deal is not built on trust. Iran has agreed to extraordinary transparency and verification. The International Atomic Energy Agency, the IAEA, is the premier organization in the world for detecting and monitoring nuclear activity in all the countries that have signed up to the Non-Proliferation Treaty. At declared sites, inspectors will have regular access with as little as 2 hours' notice. International inspectors will have access not just to enrichment facilities, but also to the full uranium supply chain, from mines to centrifuge manufacturing and operation. And this access to the uranium supply chain comes with a 25-year commitment. To evade detection, Iran would need to successfully hide an entire supply chain, and that would be an extremely risky and difficult undertaking. At undeclared sites, suspected of nuclear activity, inspectors would have access in as few as 24 hours. If Iran disputes access to a site, this agreement provides a crucial new tool by providing a specified time, 24 days, to gain access. To be clear, the duration of the agreement is indefinite. Some provisions will be in place for 10 years, others for 15, and still others for 20 or 25. But transparency requirements and Iran's most fundamental obligation, its commitment to the United States and our partners to forego a nuclear weapons program, are permanent. The science that underpins this agreement gives me confidence that this is the best possible opportunity to eliminate the existential threat of an Iranian nuclear weapon and protect America, our allies, and global security. Thanks for watching.